Yeah, so firstly, is it okay for me to tape record this conversation?
Of course.
Yeah, firstly, I would just like to ask, what are some of the best way for students in university and underprivileged people to get the free legal advice and support that they actually need?
Well, it depends on the type of problem which they want advice for. There are some various community legal centres that are located throughout Sydney and in other regional areas that will provide free legal advice, and sometimes will take on small cases. In certain types of specialist areas, there are specific legal centres that deal with particular types of problems. For example, people with immigration or refugee status problems can go to the Refugee and Advice Service. People who have complaints about discrimination can go to one of the other particular legal centres that specialise in that type of problem. There's a homeless persons legal centre that provides free legal advice to homeless people. There's a disability legal centre which provides advice and information to people with disabilities. So there are a broad range of legal centres that are based in the community where people can get free advice. Also, the Legal Aid Commission of New South Wales, which is a statutory authority set up by the government but independent, has offices in Sydney and throughout New South Wales, and they also provide a free legal advice service. Also, the Law Society provides a referral service to refer people with legal problems to legal practitioners, and also the Bar Association has a pro bono legal service that will provide representation in some cases for people with problems who may need a barrister. And there is the Public Interest Advocacy Centre, which is a specialist legal centre in the city, which will provide advice for people who have cases where there might be some broader public interest involved. And also there's the Public Interest Law Clearinghouse, which also provides advice and referral to private law firms that will take cases on a pro bono basis. It used to be the case that at local courts in New South Wales there were chamber magistrates who would give advice in relation to civil matters, but I don't know whether that service still exists. And also most lawyers in private practice will usually see people and give free advice at the initial consultation, but it depends on the type of problem and the type of matter. If someone, for example, had suffered a personal injury, then most law firms will provide free advice and also handle cases on the basis that they only expect to be paid if the case is successful and results in compensation. So there were a wide range of organisations through both the private profession, through the bar, through community legal centres and through the legal aid scheme that provide specific advice and assistance. I don't know whether there's any specific organisation within the University of Sydney that will assist people at all. I don't know what the answer to that is.
What are some of the most common legal issues the university student might face while studying during the studying years?
I don't know, I should ask you. I guess university students are like all people. They get involved in disputes, they may have debts, they may be involved in an accident, they may be a victim of crime. I don't know what the most common problems are that are experienced by legal centres. I'm not aware of any research which has addressed that. Although there's an organisation in New South Wales called the Law and Justice Foundation which is currently doing research on what types of legal problems people experience, and it may well be that they have information on what sorts of problems university students have. It used to be the case that the community legal centres kept a record of the types of advice they gave and also kept a lot of background information on the people who came to them, and they might be able to identify whether students are amongst their client group and, if so, what types of legal problems they have. But I don't know whether university students have any problems which are different from the community. Maybe they do, maybe they don't.
Yeah, can you tell me a little bit more information about in regards to legal aid, please, New South Wales?
Well, it's a scheme set up administered by the Legal Aid Commission, which is an independent commission. It provides representation across a broad range of matters. It provides free advice and representation in civil and criminal matters and in family law disputes. But these days, legal aid is not very readily available for civil litigation because of cutbacks in funding. but usually there's free advice and information. There are also other legal centres operated through the Legal Aid Commission or funded by the Legal Aid Commission that provide specific advice in certain types of matters, maybe for tenants or for migrants or for people who are victims of discrimination or who have a visa application if they're refugees. I mean, it very much depends on the particular type of problem. The legal resources, there's a handbook published by the Redfern Legal Centre in Sydney, and I can't remember what it's called. I think it's called the Law Handbook. It has a whole section in it which has a list of all of the organisations that provide legal aid, and the Legal Aid Commission also has a website, as do most of the legal centres. So if you do a Google search on Legal Aid New South Wales, then that will give you a list of organisations and will provide you with background information on what they each do.
What can you tell me about the website lawlink.com?
Nothing, never heard of it.
What if in international students in particular, what is the most common form of legal problem they might actually meet? Do you have any knowledge?
No, I don't. I guess if they're an international student, they're only here for a limited period of time. They have a restricted visa. They may have a problem if they want to stay in the country beyond their visa, particularly if they stop studying, in which case they may not continue to be eligible to remain in Australia. But I'm not aware of what particular problems international students experience. It may be one of the counselling services within the university would have a better idea, because even though these organisations don't necessarily provide legal advice, they often help people, particularly foreign students who have problems. And those problems may have a whole range of different aspects to them. They may be financial, they may be to do with housing, they may be to do with studying, or they may have a legal aspect to it, but I don't know.
Thank you very much. Thank you for your time.
That's it?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm off the